I'm here. This is Nevermore of the nevermore.com, also Nevermore TV. We're going to see if some people are going to come in. We're live right now over here on Facebook. All right, let's invite some of our friends over, guys. Invite some of your friends. I had a couple people who really wanted to hear this information, and I just want to make sure the young lady who asked me this question gets in on this, all right? So we're going to just share this on out. How are you? If you're coming in, comment below where you're coming in from, okay? I want to know where you're coming in from. Shout your city out. I want to be able to go behind and say, hey, thank you so much for watching, okay? So awesome, awesome. Okay? We're not going to hold on too long, guys, all right? And we're going to start going in. All right. So first, this is a sponsored Facebook Live. We are sponsored by the following. Okay. We are sponsored by All Green Cleaning, www.allgreencleaning.biz. www.allgreencleaning.biz. All right. Run on over there for your complimentary carpet session. All right. Carpet session. They will come on out to your house or your business and give you a free estimate. Isn't that awesome, guys? So go on over there and get that done. Number two, we are sponsored by Simple and Chic Junkie. Simple and Chic Junkie. www.simpleandchicjunkie.com. Go on over there. They have complimentary virtual styling sessions opening up right now. Okay, guys, and you can have those done via FaceTime as well. All right. Last but not least, www.pawmates.com. www.pawmates.com, spelled P-A-W-W-M-A-T-E-S. All right. That is the next biggest thing, social media site for everybody except for humans. All right. It is for pets. If you're looking for someone to talk to about your pet or someone to share funny videos about your pet and to find a friend for your pet, go to www.pawmates.com with two W's. All right. Awesome. And that is it for our sponsored posts. Awesome. Okay, and if you want to be featured in my Facebook Live and want me to mention your business, no problem. Inbox me sponsor so I can send you the link to get that application in. Awesome, awesome. So let's get to the goods, guys. Let's get to the goods because I had a good friend of mine come to me and say, how do you get motivated once you have been worn out by your business? Okay, the excitement has worn off. You no longer feel excited about your business. You no longer feel that energy rush coming through your veins, like, oh my gosh, I want to do this business. I'm so excited for it to take off, right? So the whole question is, why do you feel like this? Why are you no longer motivated to do your business? Why are you no longer driven by your business, right? So these are some things you have to ask yourself. Why do I feel this way? Why do I not want to post? Why? Hi, Ebony B. How are you? I'm Inspired 816. So glad you joined us, love. And this is actually so, so, so great. I'm so happy you're here. We were just getting into how to get motivated when the excitement has worn off in your business. All right? Awesome. Let's talk about it. The big question is why? Why do you feel like this? Why are you no longer motivated to do your business, no longer motivated to promote your business and to talk about your business and to be the business? Why do you feel like this, right? The thing is, you are pouring out so much content. You are pouring out so much energy in your business. You are pouring out the love and the excitement out in your business every single day when you're posting, every single day when you're telling someone about it. But the thing is, you have to refill that cup being yourself. The cup is a symbolic of you, okay? You have to refill that cup. You keep pouring out and pouring out and pouring out and never putting back, you're gonna feel depleted. You're gonna feel half empty. You're no longer gonna have energy and excitement for your business, right? So what's the first thing you do to pour into yourself? One, go to God. Start praying. Whoever you believe in, go to your higher power and ask them for guidance. Thank you so much for coming to me, and I'm praying that I get understanding and clarity in my business and my life, right? It's a simple prayer. You can just put it out there in the universe saying that you're asking for help. You want some direction. You want some excitement in your life. You want something to change, right? Number two, then you want to look for a mentor if you don't already have one. If you already have one, or if you're following someone who you consider your mentor online, on Instagram, or in your email list, whatever you choose to follow, go back to that person. Go watch their old videos. Go to YouTube, right, and look for motivational videos. Go to Earl Nightingale on YouTube and go for the 30-day challenge to change your mindset. The whole thing is you can only control your mind. You need to start controlling it as far as your thoughts that you're putting out there in the universe to be excited. It's time to get back to why. Why did you decide to be a business owner? That's the next part. Why? Let's revisit our why. If you don't have a big enough why, you won't feel that extra push. Entrepreneurship is not easy. Being a business owner is not easy. You have to be self-disciplined. You have to be self-motivating, okay? You have to tell yourself, hey, I want to get up and do this thing and do it big every single day. You have to be your own hype man, right? Your own hype man. So how can you be that? You have to pour into yourself. And how do you pour into yourself? You read books. You watch videos, you listen to podcasts, you watch lives just like this to get inspired. The whole point of why you're no longer motivated is because you're no longer inspired to do what you're doing. In my friend's case, she is in a fashion industry. She is a boutique owner. So how to get inspired as a boutique owner? You need to start searching out people who you resonate with, who inspire you, who make you level up, who push you that extra, that extra 10% that maybe you wouldn't do by yourself because you no longer feel like you can do it. Like I said, go to YouTube, type in Earl Nightingale, the 30-day challenge, or just type in motivation. Just hearing those videos every single day will change your mindset because you're feeding your spirit. You're feeding yourself nothing but good things. And then in return, once you feed yourself that knowledge, you can then spit it out to others. You can then put it in your content and you won't feel overwhelmed. You won't feel as though you're losing something because you are keep replenishing yourself. You keep adding new things into your brain. You keep motivating yourself to keep going, right? That is what I recommend, all right? So it's time to go to the gas station, guys. That's ultimately what it is. It's time to go to the gas station, which is inside of our spirit. We need to gas up. We need to get energized. We need to get excited. Hello, Joy Davis of the Church Chick. That is my hello, gorgeous. That is my honeybee. You go follow the Church Chick, okay? She is going to give it to you raw, straight cut, and let you know everything you need to know about being an awesome, awesome, awesome Church Chick, all right? So like I said, you want to get in that prayer. You want to pray to your higher power and ask them for guidance. Ask them for a way to keep going. Right? Number two, start looking into those old emails. You know how we subscribe to stuff and then we don't even open it. We don't even look at the webinars. We don't even attend, right? Go through those old emails and see the people who you liked and who you signed up with to get some inspiration. And if you're in the fashion industry, get you some Vogue books. Get the Vogue app. Go to style.com. Get excited about being in the style industry. You have a voice. Now it's time to use it. Start pouring into yourself so you can pour into others. All right. Don't stop at just the self-care industry and that whole little thing. You still have to learn something new every day in your niche. You have to, or you will feel depleted, non-motivated. Like you want to give up. You don't want to market. You don't want to post. You don't want to do this. And sometimes we get so hung up about being an adult and what we don't want to do, and we don't do it. And then you're wondering why you're not making money. You're not doing monetary activities. You're not going live. You're not emailing your list. You're not growing your list. You're not talking to your audience. You're not showing up for them, but you're sending them links to say, pay me. No, they're not going to pay you. They are not going to do it like that, all right? And so, and then again, remember your why. Remember why you're doing this. For me, why am I a business owner? Because I got sick and tired of working for someone else. I got sick and tired of someone else controlling my paycheck. I got sick and tired of only getting a 30-minute lunch. I got sick and tired of dropping my kids off and not seeing them for like 12 hours of the day. I got sick and tired of someone telling me I can't go on vacation this week because I don't have enough hours. I get sick and tired of running late to the babysitter and then paying an additional fee because I was so late. I got sick and tired. So that's my why. When I tell myself, oh, I could just go get a job. It's easy to just go get a job and work for somebody for 40 hours a week. It's very easy. What's hard is me being determined and believing in myself and having faith in God that He would not put these feelings in my heart to help people in the business world if it wasn't for me. And I know it's for me because I'm so passionate about it. And so you have to remember your why. Why did you get in business? What is it? For money? Is it income? Are those the reasons? And why do you feel unmotivated? Is it because you're not making the money that you thought you would? So then you have to go back to your business model. What amount of money will your business model allow you to make? For example, if you do have a boutique and you're in that industry, being a boutique owner is a very tedious job. It's not as glamorous as some people may think. You have to make sure you have a profit margin. You have to make sure you will earn a profit on these items you're selling. And if you want to have freedom in your life, it's only so much product you can sell. And if so, you need to be running an ad to that store in order to generate a whole bunch of little sales. Or you can have a high ticket business model where you sell only high ticket items. For example, $1,000 here, $500 there, $2,500 there. And you don't need that many clients or that many sales to have the freedom that you want. So it's all in your goals. How do you want your business structured? What type of business do you have? What type of money do you want to make? And then you have to reverse engineer that. You have to know what motivates you. Some people are motivated by money. Some people are motivated by the feeling they get when they complete a task. Just for example, you have some teachers. Teachers don't have a big salary, but they are motivated by helping children, by being that person who is helping mold a young individual into something greater. They're not in it for the money. They're successful because they're doing what they plan to do and they actually accomplished it. It's not about the money, right? It's not about the money. So you have to find out your why. Why are you in this business? And then you have to keep feeding yourself knowledge. You have to keep feeding your spirit, staying prayed up, staying around like-minded individuals who make you level up, continuously have your why in your face, see your goals at hand, and make sure they're right in front of you, okay? So this was just a little bit of what I do in my Lux Biz mentorship program. I have packaged up a course where we work one-on-one to help take your business to the next level. And we do that in four different stages. One is mindset. And that's why I show you how to train your mind to be a business owner and no longer an employee. It is a big difference. And you have to learn how to invest in yourself, in courses, in paid advertisements, in your time. And you want to allocate that the right way. You don't want to just go out there willy-nilly. All right. And then number two, branding. You want to make sure when someone Googles you, you pop up. You can Google my name right now, Nevermore, and I'm right there like this. Because why? I do SEO, which is search engine optimization. And I make sure that if you type my name, even if you do M-O-O, I'm here. I'm right there. Boom. I'm popping up right there in your face. Okay. That's branding. And I want to make sure that if someone does this for your company, that they can find you no matter what. Number three, how to manage your business and your money. How to manage your business and your money. A lot of people are out here making money, but they're not managing it. How much money did you make last week? And you have no system to tell you, no reports to get. Tax season is approaching, guys. Going over there to my girl, Lysandra Everett. She's the tax lady. She'll let you know it's going down this year. If you don't have your stuff together, you might be in trouble. That's all I'm going to say. You might be in trouble. And if you're a home business owner, you want to make sure you know your expenses, what's going out, what's coming in. You want to see that. All right. You want to. And then number four that I go through in my Lux Biz mentorship program is automation. Automation. It's one thing to generate 50 leads in one day, but when you have to respond to all 50 at one time and it can be very tedious. I show you how to set up systems to be able to answer for you. reply to that text for you, send that link on over for you based off of the conversation that your client sends you in the inbox. We can do all of that. And I show you how to organize your mind, your thoughts, and generate that content without feeling that pressure. It can be very easy if you repurpose your content, right? So that's what I do with my Lux Biz Mentorship. I take you from A to B, show you how to market yourself, automate some systems, and we implement it together. I don't just send you the link and tell you to go do it by yourself. So if you're interested in that, just inbox me the word Lux, and then we can start with your Lux Biz Mentorship today. Right. So I hope you found value out of this. I hope you like this. If so, let me know your thoughts. Inbox me if you have any questions and or concerns. And always know that you can do whatever you want. Never say never, because I am nevermoreofthee.com. That's how my name came about. Never say never. Never say what you're not going to do. I would have never thought I would be an at-home business owner with my kids, making money from my expertise with something that I love to do. And so I help zealous moms and women come online and retire their 9-to-5, package their passion for profit. And if that's something that you're interested in, let me know and we can work together. And always have a great, great day. Stay blessed. Nevermore here of thenevermore.com. Bye-bye.